Ah, there he is! Not on!
Come on, let's go. We have to stop him. Nomura, stay out of this and defend Keenfire.
It is always a pleasure to run into you, Tundil Goldhand. I've been waiting for you and your companions for a while now. And it would seem we have caused you a few losses.
This ends here, Cintharas.
You took the words right out of my mouth. Leave none of them alive.
Why didn't you just kill us sooner? Like, you're the villain, and we're the ones to try and stop you. You had tons of options. You literally had your knife to my throat twice already. And you just keep not doing it. So I guess you're just stupid. Kind of nullifies the whole villain thing a little bit in your effectiveness. If you're just real dumb. And that seems to be the case. I'm going to go with these guys. Seems like a no-brainer to use Gandagar because he has a buff for old people nearby that's just passive, making them more powerful. Tungdil's obligatory. Andokai has a heal. And Nomura is badass, kind of. Maybe don't have to use Nomura, but isn't she the one that has the item? I suppose maybe I don't need to use her and she'll just automatically go after people. Let's see, I do need to unequip one of these skills and replace it with something better. Let's get rid of the assassination and replace it with this, I think. Yeah. Shadow Death is good for doing damage to a bunch of enemies, and the other one can be spammed on one particular enemy, but using both of these is too much, because it's two slots being used up, and they both have 2-minute cooldowns, which is way too long of a cooldown. So I'm going away from that now. Let's see, you changed my skills without asking me. Let's get rid of Cleave and go back to Blacksmith's Blow. The force of his actions is raised. Force isn't necessarily damage, though, is it? It doesn't say damage, it says force. And force seems like it could be the physics of everyone getting knocked back and stuff, and that's not really a high priority thing for me. I'd rather have the defense bonus, really. Maybe even Leader's Will, perhaps? Yep, you unequipped spells, too. Squall is a knockback, it seems kind of neat. I think I like my existing skills, though, so please don't unequip my chain healing without me knowing. That's kind of a bummer. Okay. What do you have equipped right now? It'd be kind of nice if the items would show up here under each portrait, so you can see what they have equipped right now, because otherwise you have to scroll back and forth and look for their face. I don't think he has anything equipped right now. So I could go for the talisman, or the bonus AP, which would let me attack more often with all these different attack skills I have, so maybe that's the way to go. Do these have cooldowns? 1 second. 2 minutes. 1 second. So he gets temporary double damage, but everything else is not cooldown based. We have some healing potions. Yeah, we still have a few left. I think I'll give him the AP. Might need to leave the main character on healing potions just in case. Think everything else is good to go? Should work out, I hope. Try not to die. Oh! Dumping straight into the fight. Okay. Our goal is to kill Cintharas. And only Cintharas, apparently. Maybe I'll get lucky and use a cleave or something and he'll just get one shot like the previous boss fight did. Unlikely, yeah. But still. Okay, so... Actually, let's go for the rapid fire attack. Oh, he teleported away. Alright, well, that happens. Waste of time. Fine. Whoa! Nomura just took a huge spike of damage from that last one. Okay. What's happening over there? Are those villagers? I think they're villagers. I thought they were attacking groundlings, but those look like they're villagers, yeah. Well, he's gonna be a bit of a problem to get to. We can go after his horse, I guess. That'll probably help. There we go. What? That's a lot of hits. Yes. Agreed. Just keep going for the hits here. There we go. No one gets a little bit of friendly fire, unfortunately, but mostly working out.
Yes?
Just die. If I keep the group together and heal relatively frequently, I can mostly just make this work, I think. Boom! Oh look, Cintharus is here. How convenient. Let's see. Let's see if I can sneak in there. Hello. Didn't really hit as much as I would hope, but it's something. Okay.
Now you've got me interested.
Well?
You might be able to get in there.
All right, then.
That'd be good. Maybe do double damage on our way in. Oh, he's not quite gone. Okay, I'm about to do double damage, so you should get out of here. There we go.
What is it?
Because if you're in here, you're going to be in trouble. There we go. How's that, Cintharus? Are you going to... No, hit. Oh, he doesn't have the AP. Whoops. Maybe he will soon. We'll just keep going for attacks for now. He's taking damage. There he is.
Too many.
He likes to stay local.
Come on.
Huh? What?
Now you've got go for another heal. Narmora's doing a little better. But she's not super durable. This will keep her safe for a little while. She'll teleport around for a little while, and that'll make it harder for her to get hit. She'll be distracted with that and won't be taking much damage, probably. I'm going to throw a random spell down. No, let's not do that.
What? Now you've got me interested.
Tungdil, you can try to come help. If he goes down, it's over, right? So that's all we need to do.
Yeah.
Keep it going. There we go. He's taking damage kind of fast.
What is it?
Gotta wait for that heal cooldown to do much else. Andokai might be able to shoot him if he came into the right spot, but right now all my teammates are very much in the way. So I prefer not to try. I'm gonna try to clear out some of the local enemies. I don't want to move her to the front line, because she'd be taking some damage. Where is the villain right now? Did he teleport away? Oh, he's over here. Oh, he's going on trips, isn't he? Okay. Let's shoot him with this, then. I see you over there. I did not mean to hit my teammate there. Whoops.
Over here. I need support.
You're in trouble now.
Right.
Try to rejoin the crew to increase chance of successful healing. You're doing fine, so I'll just have you do your defensive buff.
Yeah.
So you could do some damage here, because he's, like, just joining you in the fray right now. That's a surprisingly low damage combo, honestly. I kind of expect more from that attack than I get. Almost time for heals. There we go. Okay, so the heal has happened. That's good. He didn't get healed at all, though. That's less good. I can do this, though, so that's good. Fight's over.
Whoa. Keep going. We must reach the tower before more reinforcements arrive.
Hold it. If Nodon is here, then the Perished Land is here too, and no one wants to confront him again.
Oh, what have we got here? The long-lost son returns. I am glad that I met you here. I was afraid the elf wouldn't leave anything for me.
Bislipper, you return to the stronghold of your people, the stronghold of the Thirdlings.
You really are clever. Gundrabor and Balendalin took a lot longer to realize who I am, but then it was already too late for them.
I'll cut you into pieces, Thirdling.
You ever notice how Cintharus is kind of built up as the most dangerous thing in the game? Not more so than Nodon, perhaps, but... He's like your constant mustache-twirling villain that's just an inch away from murdering you at any moment. But every time we fight him, he's just like no big deal. You just go up to him and stab him a bit. He dies. It's easy. He actually... I think he might have been less durable than that one mage was that would control the golem. The one that would... I don't think he even got a name and wasn't even a character in the story. Granted, in my final attempt against him, he died in one hit. which was hilarious and nonsensical. But I think he technically had more hit points than the guy we just took down after an entire game of build-up to that boss fight. It was just the same fight we had two times ago. Every single time it's just, oh, I'm Synthoris. I kind of fight and teleport a little bit. Oh, I'm dead. That was scary and tough. It wasn't tough. So we have injuries to contend with. Oh, we have a lot of injuries to contend with. Let's take you guys both out. I'll bring in Boindil. He's uninjured. Tungdil, thankfully, isn't particularly injured. He did a good job at not dying in that one. Andokai can try to heal, so that's good. Jerun might be a good person to bring in here. Jerun or Ballard? Yeah, let's do Ballardus. Ballardus has our new second breath reset, which should be good. You should grab the skill of one of the other characters, the item of one of the other characters that's no longer with us right now. Maybe the heal, because you can do rapid fire attacks, especially with that reset, and that could benefit you. You could do bonus damage on auto attack. Yeah, let's have to do that happen. He has an auto attack that doesn't hit teammates, so I feel better about doing the bonus damage on auto attack to him. And you might need the heals. You're pretty uninjured, though. So maybe I should do something else. Go for bonus defense. Sure. We'll see how this goes.
Kill the traitor, Bissilpur. Bislipur.
Vaguely how you pronounce it. Oh, there's a whole battle happening back there. You can see, like, siege weapons or something over there. And there. There's a decent bit of background over there. I guess we climbed up this thing? We must have if we're standing here. They just kind of skipped ahead on that part. Okay, so this guy's a dick. Let's go murder him in the face. Shouldn't be too bad. Let's get started. Yeah. Boop. Hmm? Go for the heal.
And again.
Oh, Tungdil, I didn't want to include you in that one. Damn it. Alright.
If I have to.
Wasn't my goal. Laser time! Oh my god. Was that Bissilpur or an orc? I think that was Bissilpur. No, that's Bissilpur. That was just some orc? Okay. For a brief second there, I thought I one-shot the boss again, and that would have been hilarious. But that was not what was happening. I just lost track of him in the horde a little bit. Get on Bissilpur, please. Yeah. No, don't hit that guy. Hit this guy. Yeah, hit the boss. Ow. Oh, I lost control of him.
What is it?
That's not good.
I'll tell you when I'm ready.
I lost complete control of him, and I'm not ready to heal yet.
Yes?
So that's bad, too. Maybe you can get in there real quick.
I'll be ready soon.
Yes?
Now
you're ready to heal yet? Boindel's pretty close to going down, and I can't do much about it because I can't control him right now. That's unfortunate.
What is
it? A few steps to make that character. We'll double up on the damage resistance stuff. Okay.
Huh? What is it?
Let's get a few more blows in real quick.
Just a moment.
Uh-huh. How you doing? It? The heal's ready? Magic. Mash that heal. Time. There we go.
What is it?
All right, I can do this over and over again.
Oink, oink, little piggies.
Lost track of that a little bit.
What
Although now
mean?
He's now he might die very quickly.
Yes.
Well, you're really far away from your foe right now. Let's try to close that gap again, perhaps. Oink, oink, might have been a bit of a mistake. Oh well, gotta double down on it now. It's the only thing that's keeping him alive is the oink, oink. That's all the AP he's got. Okay. Balandis, why are you having trouble closing the gap? He's like weirdly far away. Okay. Just keep. There we go. Keep landing blows. Alright, so Boindel's down now. And we are not even particularly ready to do things there. Let's blast this guy to hell. There we go. That fixes that problem a little bit.
Yes?
You just keep hitting this guy.
Right away.
Just keep hitting him. There we go. Come on.
I'll be ready soon.
Land the hits.
Yes.
Alright, can you heal yet? Yep. Oh, this is gonna hurt. There it goes.
It's over, Bislipur. If you submit, Gandagar will...
I don't care about Gandagar! I just needed someone on the throne I could steer as I wish. War against the elves was the goal.
The kingdoms were to wear themselves out against the elves. Then the children of Lorimbo would have had it easy. It was you who murdered Gandagar's father and brother, wasn't it?
I would never do anything like that to another dwarf! Ah! Fool! You have no idea who you really are.
I think I see where this is going. So we're going to find out that Tungdil is a member of the Dwarf Killer faction, and they kill dwarves. How the fuck did... What the fuck is a Dwarf Killer? Like, we've heard the idea that there's, like, a third... The Thirdlings are, like, some group of orcs that hate orcs for... I mean, sorry, orcs. Sorry, that's the wrong word altogether. That the Thirdlings are supposed to be dwarves that hate dwarves, I guess? Why? How do you have a race that wants to kill itself? Do they think that they're somehow exempt from dwarfiness? It'd be cool if this was like a developed plot point or something. It probably is in the book. I hope it is in the book. And I hope they're not cartoonishly evil, stupid characters and actually have like some actual writing behind them that makes a little bit of sense, because it's really hard to accept the idea that there's just an arbitrary chunk of the dwarves that wants to kill all dwarves for some reason. And that's a completely undeveloped plot point up at this point, and I think the game's about to end. So, I think the plot twist is going to be that Tungdil's a Thirdling, but we barely understand what that means. So that's not great. It's like five characters are currently unwounded. That's good. I like that it's giving me a results screen on health. Experience when nobody can get experience anymore. 33 experience to 33 provisions. Why? Am I gonna ever walk? Because we just went across the entire map, and I didn't even have to walk here. So I don't know if these provisions are ever gonna help.
This is an historic moment. Faced with the ultimate evil, the races of Girdlegard join forces. I must pack this down.
There's not on.
We must take Namora up there, clear the way for her, and then end it, Namora.
Alright, so this might be it. As everyone... Yep, everyone's injuries are magically healed. Almost as if they realized that it was a bad idea to have people go into big fights with injuries. Almost as if that mechanic should have been not in the game ever. Or at least not in the last several fights I did. Like, it hasn't made sense for a while. And the fact that they arbitrarily break their own rules by just making it disappear when it's convenient to them kind of seals the deal on how stupid this entire mechanic is to this game, and how it doesn't really generally make sense. Ah, well, I guess. Alright, so I think I want my damage boost back. You die fast, let's not deal with you right now. So I'll bring you back. Probably keep him with the... No, I'll give him the auto attack bonus one, I guess. Everyone else is probably happy with what they got. It doesn't hurt to give you a little regeneration there. The health regen thing doesn't seem like it ever really helps that much. And nobody's been leveling up, so all of my skills should be exactly where I left them. Also, that's what I figured. I was gonna say, I hit escape to try to open this menu, and it made the mission start, so that's unfortunate. But, thankfully I think I was set up correctly. Oopsie. Has it been saving at all? Okay, it has been auto-saving. Because I was going to say, I've been incapable of making manual saves for most of this time, actually, because it keeps going directly from cutscene to fight to cutscene to fight, and you can't make saves during cutscenes or fights. You can only make them when you're free-roaming in a peaceful situation. Which is a little rough. Alright, so I think this is the final fight in this room. So our goal is to get Namora on the balcony. Where's the balcony? That balcony? Oh shit, I'm not playing as Namora. I guess we have to clear the way. This is kind of a case of the game's rules breaking again, by the way. Shit, could I have... Shit. I didn't know this was the objective. Was Nermora on the previous screen? Damn it, I don't remember. If Nermora was on the previous... If you can control Nermora, I could just teleport there instantly. Boop. Mission over. I don't know if I could... I don't know if I could have controlled her, though. I didn't check if she was an option, because I didn't know about the objective until the mission started. Do they show up on the level, on that screen when you're picking your characters? I don't remember if they do, but I don't think they do. AoE! Alright, so can I control her? Nope, she's a neutral character. Okay. Well, fighting time.
Understood. Yeah.
Just keep pushing. Sure, I hope she's smart enough to go the right way when she needs to. Just gonna sort of do a bunch of AoE whenever I can. It's effective. That didn't really hit as many people, but sure. She's fun to use. Oh, you're dying, huh? Where are you? What are you fighting over here that's so tough? One guy? That's a bummer. I'm gonna run away a little bit just to try to deal with that a little bit. Just gonna try to land some heavy hitting blows to hopefully clear the way for our other character. Nermora's over there. Just gonna keep doing AoE over there because none of my characters are there.
I can't do this on my own.
What do you need?
You're not doing well right now. Let's activate your cooldown. You'll hopefully make good use of that. See, I think I can do my heal by now. Yep. Really? You're standing right next to Gandagar, but you didn't heal Gandagar. Why? Why can't I control that skill? Also, why aren't you running towards the objective? Go over there. This is out of the way of your objective. Crap. Alright, let's use both of my defensive abilities to make my character last longer, hopefully. And I'm gonna jump over here. Oh shit. That kinda made things worse. Alright, well, I don't think I can save him at this point. Maybe a little. Lasers! Probably helped a little bit. Yeah, that probably bought him a little time. Whee! Let's just get you away from the enemies for a bit. Hey, look, this is where all the humans hang out. That's probably helpful. Is she dying? She's dying. She's dying, and I cannot control her. Oh, the heal affected her. Weird. Oh, is the heal affecting random... It's affecting random humans, too. I didn't know that the heal could affect non-party members, because other skills could not affect party members before. Unfortunately, it didn't reach my character that's actually about to die. There's not much keeping him alive, huh? Maybe if I just go hang out at the objective, people will follow up on that. Look, Gandagar's at the objective. If only the character I can't control would go there. She's about to die. Ah. A plus AI right there. Yep. Oh no, she died! What the f... What kind of AI is that? What kind of AI is that? She just stands around and dies. Why would you design your AI like that? I'm so baffled by that. It's just kind of embarrassing. Oh no, I can't control her. Oh no, I can't play as her, so I can't... The game's breaking its own rules. All I have to do is teleport. It would take 1 second, the whole fight would be over, because my only objective is to get her over there. But instead, I can't control her arbitrarily once she's important. The moment she has an objective to complete, now she's an idiot neutral character I can't control that just walks around and dies. How do I... There's just hordes of enemies everywhere. How do I get her to go to the objective? Like, how do you do that? I'm genuinely baffled and confused by this. How do you say, hey, you, character I can't control, go over there, that place that's like 20 feet away, and end the mission? She went everywhere except for that, and then died. A plus game design.
gold star.
All right, I'm just going to take my four bulky characters, and I'm going to just try to push her, maybe? Got to keep the healer around, of course. Yeah. She won't go to the door, and if she goes to the door, we win. So I might have to clear a path first, but I think I'm just going to try to physically push her to the exit, because that's what this game has come to, apparently. Okay. Hey, everyone. Just going to awkwardly shove her. No, we gotta kill the local enemies first. Alright, first localized heal. Okay, and a guy's taking damage. Here, you, Tungdil, just push her. Push her. No, it's not working. No, push her. No. Okay, that kind of works, I guess.
Understood.
Push her. Push her.
Understood.
On my way. Understood. On my way. Pervacus. Understood. On my way. Understood. On my way. Fucking move, lady. No. Ah, she's stuck a little bit. No, this was working.
I was expecting more of a battle.
Where are you? I'm not.
I can't do this on my own.
Stop ignoring my input. Go where I'm clicking.
That was good training.
At once.
Understood. At once. Okay, so you need to heal everyone, hopefully. Okay. How'd you get behind her again?
I need some help.
Keep pushing her.
Understood.
Keep pushing her. Come on, we're so close. She has to go around the corner. You stupid shit. Okay, it's fine. It's fine. She literally just has to go to the exit. She has to move a few feet. It's the most basic action we've done throughout the entire game. But no, I can't control her. So now it's hard all of a sudden. For some reason. When she has a teleport skill, was that just canonically removed from her repertoire? She doesn't have that anymore? Is that what I'm supposed to think? She just magically lost the ability to teleport that she's had the entire game.
Vile creature.
Sure, why not? How do you make her go to the exit? I've practically cleared the path in the past, and that didn't matter. Also, Gandagar's half dead, and we've been fighting. This level's been active for like a few seconds. What the hell?
What is it?
Okay, let's blast you to hell. Okay. Maybe I can just suck her in that general direction? Didn't really work, no. It was a worthy attempt.
What is it?
But not quite.
Yes. On my way.
I really think I just have to push her. On my way. On my way. At once. 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 At once. A plus fucking game design, you fucking embarrassment. Jesus Christ, that really worked.
Master, they have destroyed the siege tower. And Kai.
There's nothing you can do to harm her. I will take care of her myself.
Master, watch out!
I'll get the axe!
Oh no! She got taken out! If only Tungdil, who is definitely a thirdling, the enemy of the dwarves, would wield the axe and save the day! That's what's happening now, obviously. That's exactly what's gonna happen now. Alright, well, I'll go get the axe with my nice Look, a mobility skill! If only she would use hers a second ago.
Do you want this axe? Brother?
I am not your brother, traitor.
We are both the same, Tungdil. We are both children of Lorimbur, thirdlings.
I am not like you. You open the gates of Ogre's death. You have murdered dwarves. I am not a thirdling. I am a fourthling.
Not like me! Oh! It is our destiny to avenge ourselves on the others, Tungdil. And in Nod On, we have finally found someone who can eliminate the other kingdoms for us!
You have put Girdleguard in the hands of evil just to...
No, not just, but precisely for that reason. To finally fulfill our destiny, as our kingdom has tried to do for thousands of cycles.
Enough! You are completely blinded.
Tungdil really shouldn't be bothered by this. Also, this is really obnoxiously Star Wars.
No, I am your father. No, it's not possible. It can't be. No. My father was a moisture farmer,
or whatever. Like, all this is what we're doing here, is this whole... We're doing the I am your father, Darth Vader, Luke Skywalker situation. He's not my father, but he's like,
we're from the same kingdom. This is your parentage. Your shocking parentage that is suddenly relevant at the end of the story. Whoa.
And yeah, instead of being distraught, because who gives a shit? Who gives a shit, honestly? I mean, maybe don't advertise the fact to other dwarves that you're descended of the people that apparently killed dwarves? Apparently? Don't advertise that around, because that would probably go poorly for you. But maybe just, you know, be happy that that means you can wield the axe and save the day? I would just be happy about that in this situation. It's, you have the power to win now. That's great news. That's fantastic news. Fucking use it. All right, let's... I'm going to hit him in the face a lot now. I have a lot of damage-reducing things, so he shouldn't be able to hurt me very much. But he'll still try. What the fuck just happened? We got stuck... Even the... We're at the end of the game right now, and I want to point out that I just completed an objective by taking a neutral NPC and using my character's hitboxes to shove them into the goal so that we could finish the mission. Because that's what this game has come to. But a second ago, we just glitched through this tombstone and my character just flipped out and pathed around through what... Yeah, that was through a wall. He went... Because they're not supposed to go back there. This fight has been in real time for about 2 seconds and it already broke and lost its shit again. Because this game is... basically an alpha that was sold to people for money. And that should not be acceptable. This is... this product should not be sold to people in this state. Also, I know this... I guess it's supposed to be thematically interesting that we're having a one-on-one showdown, but this is really boring to play. It's just a one-on-one fight, so it's like auto-fight.
There is no greater goal for either of us than destroying the other kingdoms. When they are gone, all of the ranges belong to us.
Don't talk as if it relates to me. I set off to stop Nod On and to save the Dwarven Kingdoms in Girdleguard. And that is exactly what I'm going to do. I can't be a thirdling.
Yes, you are one of us. I saw it immediately in the throne room of the Secondings. How did you learn to fight so well in such a short time if you hadn't inherited it? Listen deep inside yourself and you will recognize the truth.
Wow, all those sound effects played twice because this is such a well-made game. Good job.
Bye. Vrakus.
If you kill me, you will destroy Girdleguard. You can't stop the danger from the west. Only I can do that. That's why I am uniting Girdleguard.
You haven't united Girdleguard under you. It has united against you. Your terror ends here and now. Huh?
Oh.
That was good training.
Suddenly being attacked here. All right, where's my teammates? Where is that a teammate? I think that might be a teammate over there. They're hard to make out from here because everyone looks the same. Oh yeah, there's a few teammates here. Why aren't they helping me? How'd they get over there? We were all here together as a group. Now they're just kind of in random corners of the map, not being helpful. And I can't control them. So I guess this will either be a mind-numbingly easy fight where Tungdil just crushes Nod On in a few seconds, or it'll be a horribly unfair fight where I lose my entire party but are expected to still fight a group of enemies. Let's learn. Let's find out which one.
The downfall of Girdleguard will weigh upon your shoulders. You must let me live.
No, we will protect Girdleguard ourselves, just like we always have.
Okay, he died in one hit. I guess that makes sense. It's the chosen one weapon, sure.
This is a day of hope and optimism. Nodon is destroyed, and thus the power of the perished land is broken. We only managed to achieve this because the humans, the elves, and dwarven kingdoms forgot their hatred and stood strong together. Can there ever be a better sign for us to bury our feuds with each other? We have protected Girdleguard. Now, the hatred must be washed completely from our hearts. From this day on, we will write the chronicles of peace, compassion, and friendship. And here stands the dwarf who we all have to thank most of all, Tungdil Goldhand.
You can be proud of yourself.
Proud? That I am a thirdling?
You've saved all of us. It doesn't matter who you are. The only thing that counts is what you've done. Do you think there might have been a glimmer of truth in Nodon's words?
The danger from the west. With you by my side, I won't shy away from any danger, Ballandis.
Didn't the game have voice? Didn't the dialogue have lip sync at first? I feel like it used to have lip syncing and then it just stopped having lip syncing. That was weird. Like their lips didn't match their dialogue at all, and that happened for the last few cutscenes too. All right. Well, judging by that background music, which I may or may not have to cut out, so if you're not hearing somebody sing right now, it's because I cut it out because it was blocking the video on YouTube. But this was the Dwarves. It's a decent commercial for the book that may be well written, but damn, it's a bad game. It's a real bad game, and it just gets worse. I guess those are the credits. Yep. It starts off rather nice because it's easy at first. And you're just crushing everything, and you're having a fun little romp with your little characters that have nice personalities, and exploring a world that seems kind of neat. And I was enjoying the fact that, like, oh look, but all the missions had little objectives, and they kept changing the objectives, and those were fun to complete, like saving all those people from the burning village and stuff like that. That was all cool. And I liked the fact that there was situational stuff on the map, where like the orc. Like, those orc raids that were going around, they kept going to different locations, and those different locations would have different fights for you to do. Like, there was branching story stuff there that was really interesting. But, then the game got worse immediately. You finished the first map, which had all that cool storytelling and had all those many... I mean, you guys presumably watched that stuff on the way here, so you remember I was happy with the game. It was well written, it was well paced, the dialogue was good, the cutscenes were good, the scenarios of the combat were generally... It was shallow, but it was at least, like, enjoyable in its variety, and exploring the map was making cool stuff happen. So I was pleasantly happy with the whole experience. Then things got a little worse. You find out that your mentor is dead, and you go across the desert to meet with the other dwarves. Up until then, still mostly fine, but that desert was basically a straight line, so that whole zone was kind of pointless and boring compared to the first zone, what that was really well developed and interesting. And then things start to get worse, because then you get three dwarves added to your party, and you get to dump into a new world, where you then get to a town that adds three humans to your party. Now you have six new characters out of nowhere. Almost none of them have any real development, and one of them even went on to never have any real speaking lines all the way up until their death, basically. And they only get the most token development possible across the board. The new region we're dumped in had way less interesting stuff going on, especially since there wasn't you didn't meet a dwarven trader that gets murdered and then you have to follow up on that stuff. There was no moment of orc raids that move from location to location to have different scenarios. It mostly what happened was a really nonsensical quest where you investigate who stole some grain, basically. And that quest, as we went over, didn't make sense because it involved people magically teleporting across the map instantaneously, where the map is designed to tell us that every little movement cut takes a day of supplies. And then everything started falling apart, because that was when every mission was getting slightly harder, and they started becoming more and more poorly designed. It started becoming very apparent that the difficulty, it doesn't make sense in this game, because you don't have a proper party with composition that is good for strategies. You can't use hold position, so characters won't stand still when you want them to, but then oftentimes will stand still when you don't want them to and just stop fighting in the middle of a war for some reason. It became really weird and apparent that despite having a huge party, you can't use most of them in a fight for some reason that's never given, besides to have the game not make sense and be pointlessly difficult when you should have a group of 10 fighting people. The story stopped being interesting as much because the main story was poorly paced, poorly explained, so you mostly didn't have an idea of the stakes or what was going on for most of the story. And the characters were less developed. The two characters you grew close to were pushed to the sidelines to make way for all these new characters, but these new characters never got proper time to develop them, so you never really cared about them that much either because they never got properly developed and you never got to spend proper time with them. Several of them came and go and were introduced and then killed off in various ways, and it was all so abrupt and short-sighted that it just didn't really leave an impact. And that was also when the map fell apart. It became apparent that the map mostly didn't make sense, and the resource stuff didn't make sense. The resources were just nonsense and didn't, your rations didn't mean much besides your healing, but you quickly lost your ability to walk around anyway. Which was shown by the fact that, even when we entered the climax of the game, I hit the linear part where you're never going to be on the map again, and the game kept rewarding me with gold and provisions, even though I will never meet a vendor ever again to spend gold on, so the gold was pointless. And I, at that point, couldn't go to the map and walk around, so provisions were worthless. You couldn't even just spend provisions on the spot just to force your characters to get healed, because you couldn't heal them. That was too bad. So you're forced to deal with this stupid wound system that makes no sense because it just cripples your characters and makes them impossible to use at the beginning of fights, which is especially rough because the main character can never be removed from the fight. But also, the game itself acknowledges how stupid that system is because it starts arbitrarily removing your wounds at random intervals that are just nonsensical. It'll have you make three fights in a row, remove your wounds, one fight, remove your wounds, one fight, remove your wound, and stuff like that. It would remove your wounds whenever it felt like, as opposed to when it made sense. And then there's, of course, the fact that some random asshole that had no story, no personality, no name, as far as I can remember, just randomly shows up with a golem and is the toughest fight of the entire game by a mile. Because every actual named character in this game that you fight is just some random asshole that hits you a little bit, and you hit them back, and they die, and it's okay, it's over. And it's really anticlimactic. The real boss fights of this game were archers and that one guy with the golem. The hardest guy thing in the game is something I can only really refer to as that one guy. And then it tries to do big brawls at the end, and that mostly don't make sense. And It has a plot twist that I was able to guess a mile away because of how obvious they made it, because they just keep saying, Thirdling, 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 enemy of the dwarves, Thirdling, enemy of the dwarves, Thirdling, Thirdling, can only be wielded by an enemy of the dwarves. I'm like, I get it, I get it. I get it, the main character's a Thirdling and he's going to wield the weapon. Ta-da! They kept repeating themselves over and over again. They barely explain Thirdlings or why they're enemies of the dwarves. They barely touch on most elements of the enemies in general, so they're really boring enemies that are two-dimensional and stupid, and it's hard to care about how they work, so that just happens. And, yeah. Yeah. There's been a few games over the course of YouTube that have, just gone south over the course of their campaigns, and this is definitely one of them. This, might be one of the worst games I played this year. Yeah, it probably is. This game and Zenith and Anima Gate of Memories are probably the worst gameplay games I've played this year, and maybe even in the history of the entire channel. But at least Zenith had a great story with great writing and great characters, and really brought it home with great pacing and genuine humor in a video game, which is so rare. Good job, Zenith. But this game, its story, it couldn't even hold up the story part. I think that maybe the books it's based on might have held up there under the deal, but this game, the story gets stale and vague and poorly paced, and it gets jammed with too many characters that are poorly developed and just kind of feels rushed, and it feels like a mess, which maybe it was. It's, as is being made abundantly clear right now, it's a Kickstarter game, so maybe they ran out of money and just had to finish it. They sure as hell didn't have money for QA, apparently, because as you get later into the game, every single cutscene started glitching, every loading screen started glitching. You might not always see those because I cut them out because loading screens take too long and that's boring to leave in. Gameplay started glitching. The basic interface for leveling up your character started glitching. I don't know if this is for sure true or not because I can't confirm it myself, but there are reviews for the game, like Steam reviews, that claim that a ton of glitches were... this game was known to be glitchy at launch, and that supposedly there were tons and tons of forum posts on the Steam forums reporting all the problems this game had, and supposedly the developers on launch day just wiped out every single forum post on when the game was first launching so they could hide the fact that it was generally known to be a buggy, nightmarish mess. As a really shady deal to try to increase sales by suckering more people into this. So that's a bummer, too. That's rather unappealing. Yeah. That's concerning, if that's true. I can't confirm it very well. But multiple people have said that at this point, so I think it might be the case. But yeah. I do not recommend buying this game. If anything about it intrigued you, maybe check out the books. I assume they're also called The Dwarves, but it should take only a moment to confirm the name of the book that the game The Dwarves is based on. I think it's just called The Dwarves. I think it's even a book series. And maybe those are worth checking out. I think I still will, but I dread the idea that they might do sequels to this game, because I don't know if they'll have... maybe they'll turn it around, but this game has virtually no redeeming qualities besides its source material. And I really don't say that lightly. I usually have something good to say about a game, but the best I can say is that they got the rights to a good property. Everything that I found charming about the game during its first third or so completely got washed away by how much of a mess the rest of the game was, which failed to even hold up even a candle. It's not even about holding up a candle to the first part of the game. They couldn't even maintain the status quo on any basic level. The game just completely fell apart. And that's all I gotta say about this one. I'm glad it's over. Thanks for watching like always, guys. So I hope you're not too sick of hearing me rant. It's just, I think the game genuinely deserves it. And I will see you next time.